Close your eyes. Sit in Shambhavi Mudra, looking at your third eye. Both hands in Chin Mudra. Or you can have counting of beats in one of the hands. Japamala. So that you can count. First, let us chant Akara, Ukara, Makara to yourself with the higher self. Manipura to Adna. Anahata to Adna. Adna. Then Om, connect Omkara to the energy center in front of your third eye, about 12 inches, as if you are looking there. Om, you start feeling a pull there. Now you are connected, individual energy is connected to universal energy, Shakti. So first let us offer our respects to Guru and Shiva. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat, Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Om Namah Shivaya. Divine Mother Shakti, Divine Father Shiva, we are starting the meditation. We are starting the Om Namah Shivaya Japa. We all of us are participating in 5 crore Pancha Koti Shivanama Japayatna. Bless all of us. May all be purified. May Chitta Shuddhi happen in all of us. May all receive Jnana, Bhakti, Vairagya and Mukti. Bless all our family members. Bless the whole world. May all of us continue Pancha Shatakoti Japanama Yadna for Atmano Mokshartam Jagataya. Bless us. You are the father. You are the mother. You are everything for us. Protect us. Bless us. Now we'll start Om Namah Shivaya Japa in the outer world. Virat, gross world. Pancha Bhutas are Om Namah Shivaya. Attention. Om Namah Shivaya. Attention on the outer world. Space, the wind, fire, water. 5 Bhutas are Shiva. Space is Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. The wind is Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. The fire is Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Water is Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Earth is Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Everything is Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Again, fire, space. Om Namah Shivaya. The wind. Om Namah Shivaya. The fire. Om Namah Shivaya. Water. Om Namah Shivaya. Earth. Om Namah Shivaya. All 5 elements are nothing but Shiva's energy, Shakti. Shakti is one with Shiva. Now take our attention to our body, Panchakoshas. First, the physical body is Shiva. When you chant Om Namah Shivaya mantra, you experience the energy in the heart center. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Then Pranamaya Kosha, the energy body is Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Then comes the mental body, thoughts, feelings, emotions. Om Namah Shivaya. The intellectual body, ideas, thoughts, Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Pancha Koshas, Anandamaya Kosha is Shiva. My bliss is Shiva. Happiness is Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Now start from the Mooladhara, base of spine, Arohana. First Adna Chakra, chant Omkara. Om. when you chant Omkara, always there's a connection happening with the Shakti. And immediately a peaceful divine energy flows back into your heart center. Om is like a mobile connection. When you connect with the God, chant the mantra, and immediately divine energy flows back through that connection into the Adna, into the heart center. Receive the energy. Om Namah Shivaya. From Namah Shivaya, you start from the base of the spine all the way up to Swadhishta, Vishuddha. Om Namah Shivaya. Now, this Arohana. The reverse is Avarohana. Omkara at Adna Chakra again. Om. Experience the divine energy flowing back into you. Namah Shivaya. Avarohana. Like that, we'll do up and down. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. So like that, we do our spinal cord, six chakras as beats, Japamala. Of course, you can count Japa in your right hand with the bead, but this is inner Japamala. Now, take your attention to Sahasrara, the top of the head, where Shiva's matted lock is there, just above that, where Shiva and Shakti meet. Paramashiva is there, Parameshwara is there. I am one with Parameshwara. Attention should go there. Stay there in silence. If any thought comes, say, Shivoham, I am Shiva. Come down. Arohana, Avarohana. Om Namah Shivaya. So we have completed a few rounds of Om Namah Shivaya chanting, Shivoham Dhyana. So this is called Shivanama Japayadna, Panchakshari Japayadna. Let us conclude the prayer. Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityurma Amritam Gamaya. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamuduchyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Nanu Nanembudu Nanalla. Ideha Manabuddhi Nanalla. Sachidanandatma Shivananane. Shivoham Shivoham Shivoham. I'm not the body, I'm not the mind, I'm not the intellect, I'm pure consciousness, Shiva Swarupi. Atmadarshanam Brahmadarshanam Brahmadarshanam Satyadarshanam. To know the self is to know God. To know God is to be God. To be God is to know the truth. Antarjyotihi Bahirjyotihi Pratyakjyotihi Paratpara Jyotireva Jyotihi Swayam Jyotihi Atma Jyotihi Shivasmiham. I am the light of the self, awareness, Atma Jyoti. I am the light illuminating the world, Jagat Jyoti. I am the light illuminating the mind. I am light beyond all lights, Paranjyoti. I am light of love, happiness, peace, and compassion. Self-luminous light, Swayam Jyoti. Lokah samastah sukino bhavantu. Lokah samastah sukino bhavantu. Lokah samastah sukino bhavantu. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Gently rub both of your hands and open your eyes. So some instructions, okay? Whenever you have a chanting session, in the beginning, you do remember the Guru Parampara. Sadashiva Samarambha Shankaracharya Madhyamam अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंत वंदे गुरु परंपरा देन ऑफर योर स्पेशल गुरु गुरु ब्रह्म गुरु विष्णु गुरुदेव महेश्वर गुरु साक्षा परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः एंड देन स्टार्ट द प्रैक्टिस प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड ओंकार इज द वे इंडिविजुअल एनर्जी इज कनेक्टेड टू यूनिवर्सल एनर्जी इट्स लाइक ए मोबाइल वायरलेस कनेक्शन सो विदाउट द वायरलेस कनेक्शन नो स्पिरिचुअल प्रैक्टिस विल वर्क दिस वे ऑलवेज आवर ऑल टीचिंग्स ऑल मंत्रास हैव ओंकार इन द बिगिनिंग सो कनेक्ट your energy with the omkara to universal mother divine energy See the instructions for instruction for chanting session when you get to with a group or individual. Okay. Huh. Sit in a comfortable posture.
Huh.
Then
yeah, I cook.
Then pray to, then offer your respects to Guru Parampara. Sadashiva Samarambha, Shankaracharya Madhyama, Asmadacharya Paryanta, Vande Guru Parampara. Then offer your respects to Guru. Then using Omkara. Connect to the higher energy. Omkara is very important. Omkara is not a ritual. Omkara is the energy connection to the higher consciousness, Shakti. It is like a mobile phone connection. The moment you chant Akara, Ukara, Makara and Omkara, you connect it to higher consciousness. When the mobile connection is established, you offer your respect to Shiva and Shakti. Offer your gratitude, offer your thankfulness. Then do the Sankalpa. Why are you doing? Sankalpa is, we are doing Pancha, Panchakoti Shivanama Japayadna for our purification, for Jnana Bhakti Vairagya, for liberation and blessing for all our relatives and blessing for the whole world. Atmanam Oshatam Jagadida. You have to do Sankalpa. That Sankalpa will be blessed by Shiva and Shakti as energy flows back into you, your heart and body-mind complex. So then you start chanting. Om Namah Shivaya, always Om at Adna, then remaining chanting Panchakoshas, Panchabhutas, Panchabhutas, Panchakoshas, Panchachakras. In Panchachakras when you do Arohana and Avarohana. And finally, when you come to last, a few step, few chanting, you go to Sahasrara, stay in the Sahasrara. In the Sahasrara is the where Shiva and Shakti have become one. It's a Paramashiva, Parameshwara. Okay? So there you stay and mentally chant Om Shivoham, I am Shiva, if there is a thought. Otherwise, you just stay in silence. When you are done with meditation, come down to Adna, then Avarohana, Muladhara. Then the closing prayer, Asatoma, then Purnamadaha, Purnamidam. Then also, after that, Nanu Nanam Budhananala. After that, Atma Darshanam Brahma Darshanam. And after that, Antar Jyotihi Bahir Jyoti, and close with Lokaha Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Is the sequence clear to all? So this is the prayer sequence. Now you can do chanting individually or you can do chanting in a group. What is the importance of group chanting? Group chanting is group vibration is there. When all of us get together and chant, vibrate, that whole vibration is much more powerful than just individual vibrations. So that's why you have to do a regular group chanting. That's called Samuhika Japa. And that Samuhika Japa has a lot of power. But we can't do Samuhika Japa every time. So that's why you do individual Japa also. So it's like in the military, when soldiers have to cross the bridge, all of them will not march in the bridge. They'll be asked to disperse and then march. Because all of them march together. The vibrations of their footsteps can make the bridge collapse. The vibration will resonate. So what we do when we chant together, the entire vibrations will be fully resonating throughout the universe and will be very powerful. So Samuhika Sankirtana is important. Individual Sankirtana, you have to do in your place. And once you complete Japa, add the count to the form. Any questions are there? You can ask, please. Shivanama Japa is the highest form of Japa. It's Japa for Mukti Sadhana. Mukti Sadhana. Liberation. Anybody questions?
Guruji, Namaste.
Namaste, yes.
When you are doing Harinama Sankirtana and Datta Japa and Om Namah Shivaya also, so can we, when you are doing together all these three, can we do opening prayer and closing prayer, should do separately always?
No, you just make it, don't mix these japas.
Okay,
they are different energies. Okay, Harinama is actually, is Hari is nothing but nothing other than the Shakti for helping you in the Maya. Hari is when he removes your troubles in the world and removes trouble in the spiritual path. That's why it's Hari. Okay, Guru is the light who is showing you the guidance. And Shiva is the one who destroys the ignorance. So these are three different energies. Preferable to keep separate schedules. Don't mix them up. Does it answer your question?
So I got it. So that means choose different times and do it.
Yeah, there are different energies actually. There are different types of energies.
And one more question, this opening and closing prayers, for every individual chanting also we should do always, or is it directly go it to Japa?
No, it should be done. See, it's like when you chant Guru Parampara, you are invoking the blessing of all the Gurus. We are offering Guru, Guru Brahma, then you are offering the blessing of Guru, right? So it doesn't take more than half a minute, 1 minute.
Yeah, and just clarification, yes.
Yeah, right? Always, please understand, a spiritual sadhana is not a meditation practice which is taught in your commercial schools. In the sense, commercial, you will pay some 2,000 rupees and you do some meditation practice. Okay, there is no blessing involved. There is no higher consciousness involved. The spiritual practice is always with the higher consciousness. Guru and God guides it. So when you do sadhana without the prayer, without that invocation of blessings, what happens? Your sadhana becomes mental level. It will become conscious and subconscious. Your property is lower level. Whereas when you invoke the blessing, the sadhana is guided by the higher consciousness. Understand? Is the difference clear?
Got it. So,
right. So that's why many people do sadhana, spiritual sadhana, for many years, but they will not get success because they are not guided by the higher conscious. They are trying to do their subconscious mind and conscious mind try to do sadhana. It will not take them anywhere. It has to be guided by the higher energy. The entire sadhana, spiritual sadhana, is not done by me. It's not done by you. It is done through me, by Shiva, Shakti, and Guru. Have you understood the difference?
Yes, I got it.
If you say, I am doing sadhana, you are finished because you will never be able to do. You are a Jiva. Your conscious mind and subconscious mind is tiny little. The sadhana has to be done through you, body and mind, by the energy of the higher consciousness, Guru, Shiva, Shakti, or Vishnu. Your body mind should be instrument. So if you start thinking that I am doing sadhana, you are operating in the lower level. And lower level sadhana will not take you long. It's like driving a car. Driving a car will not take you to Atmadnana, higher level. It's a subconscious practice.
Yes.
Where the many of the spiritual sadhana fails, because any sadhana is not a conscious practice, it's not a subconscious practice, it's a super conscious practice. This people, we don't understand. That's why every time the Omkara is chanting is given importance, but that Omkara chanting we have done mechanically. It's not mechanical, it's connecting with the higher. Do you get what I'm saying?
And one more thing, you said about Om Namah Shivaya starts from...
What is it? Is it clear or not clear?
No, it is clear now. Now, one more thing you said about the Om Namah Shivaya start from the Agna Chakra and then go up again. So, how do you make that travel actually? Because Om comes from...
It is just attention. Nothing, no physical travel.
Okay.
Right? It is just attention movement. Right now you are looking at my image, right? Mentally you move your attention to the wall behind. Mental attention movement, that's all.
Okay.
There's no physical movement. Are you clear?
Yes.
So is the whole principle clear of Om Namah Shivaya chanting?
Prabhuji?
Yes.
I don't think this really is a doubt, but why did you name it as Panchakoti Shivanama Japayagna?
You asked me why Panchakoti Shivanama Japayagna?
Yeah, why had you named it like 5 crore Japayagna, that thing?
Japa Yadna is always a number, total number. It can be 1 crore, 2 crore, 3 crore, 5 crore, or 10 crore, or 100 crore also. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So we should take a target and commitment. What you think is reasonably possible? You should not take a big target. Let's say 100 crore is very difficult. So Pancha Koti we have taken for Panchakshari. Shivanam has 5 aksharas. It's akshara koti. Each akshara is koti. Na is akshara, ma is akshara, shi is akshara, va is akshara, ya akshara. Koti Nama for Koti Akshara. That's how we've taken. It could have been as well 10 crores or 20 crores also. But we thought 5 crores is easier. We can manage.
Okay. Okay. Right?
Anybody else? Any questions? Can you close for the day? Hariom.
Prabhuji, when you referred to the fact that this practice clears our karma, you were referring to which one of the karma, please?
See, the karmic impressions, right? There are three types. Sanchita karma, prarabdha karma, agami, and kriyamana. Correct?
Right, Prabhuji.
Prarabdha karma is what he has given body to you. It cannot, nothing can happen, nothing can be done to the body because you already got a nose, ears, your genetic material already has got.
Right, Prabhuji.
Okay. Now what will happen? When you're doing the chanting, you are already sanchita karma and kriyamana karma gets cleared. Accumulated karma.
Okay, Prabhuji.
Accumulated karma fully get burnt only when you get jnana.
Right.
Right? Jnana right. Alone is the way to burn accumulated karma. But now this will reduce the load of jnana, karma.
Okay.
And prarabdha karma also, whatever prarabdha karma is to happen, okay, that prarabdha karma intensity will come down. Karma itself will not go, but intensity will come down.
Right, Prabhuji.
Right? There's a lot of purification happens within you.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji.
The entire purpose, it's called Japa Yadna, is to burn karma, purification. Purification is the Yadna.
Understood, Prabhuji. Thank you so much.
Okay. Anybody else? Any questions? Shall we close for the day? Hari Om, please start. Okay. And now another announcement. So you make, this group has some 60 people, 70 people. I request you to make each group of 7 people, not more than 7 people. And each group should have a coordinator. This group should independently meet once in a week because to meet 70 people is almost impossible in any time. So 7-member team can meet. Okay. And this 7-member can have one coordinator. That means 8 people, 7+1 coordinator. So Gayatri ji can announce a group, the coordinate, the this thing, group names. People can join the group. So the group name should be names of Shiva. Shiva, Sadashiva, Shambho, Shankara, like that group name should be there. From Shivanam, Shiva Sahasranama, we'll take the names. So we'll make the Gayatri ji will create the subgroups. Please join the subgroups. And each group, please, one person take the coordination. Coordinator's job is simple. Once in a week, we convene the meeting. Once in a week or fortnight, to collective chanting. Individually, they'll chant. So together, we'll try to make 5 crore. Shivanama. Is there any questions for this? Anybody has any doubt?
Prabhuji.
Okay for all? Yes.
Prabhuji, so what do you mean by like meeting, Prabhuji? So is it like...
meeting, Zoom.
Okay, Prabhuji.
Right? You get together on Zoom and chant together. Collective chanting. Not physically getting together. Clear?
Okay, Prabhuji.
It's clear to all. We'll make 7 to 8 subgroups. Each group will have 7 members plus 1. And I request each one of you to become coordinators for each group. The coordinators will be in one group and rest of the people in their subgroups. So in these subgroups, please have discussion, scheduling, and all those things. This subgroup becomes one unit where you start doing practice together, maybe once in a week, once in a fortnight, depending on how you decide. But individually you continue to do that practice. So individually keep a target. Maybe I want to do 108 nama japa one day, or I want to do 256, but try to maintain that. Use a bead or use a counter, electronic counter. Are we clear? And this is intensely purifying. Okay, when I teach some sadhana, I have done it. I have already done Shivanam japa sadhana. I have done Hare Krishna japa sadhana. And I'm telling you the benefit of that. It's very purifying. Try it. I'm not telling you just something for sake of telling. Is it clear to all? So shall we close for the day?